Hi, this is Lynn from wisconsingarden.com, and we're outside today, the beginning of March. It's in the 30s, and we are looking at rabbit damage. Yes, rabbits are no longer my friend, because who knew we were going to get 62 inches of snow, and this is after some of it has melted.
Quite a bit has melted.
Yes. And I was just walking around the yard, or I should say trudging around the snow in the yard the other day, and got shocked by what I found. Whoa. The first tree I found was our sweet cherry tree. And I thought, well, that's odd that this branch is just hanging like that. And then I looked at it and I started looking at the rest of the tree, only to realize that someone has actually just chewed off all those leaves. All those branches, our main branches. And so then I thought, well, I'm going to look over here at our pear tree. I was startled.
I can't even walk in this snow.
I know.
It's my goodness.
This has totally been girdled. This whole tree now will die, except for what's under here. It will come up from the roots, but it's going to be years and years before we get any fruit off of this tree. We wrapped them in the fall, thinking we were protecting them. Think about winters of the past several years. Thought we had them high enough. Obviously not. This is just, I've never seen it this bad.
Well, what do you expect after 62 inches worth of snow so far?
Right.
And we're not even done yet.
Yes, and you look out and you find rabbit trails and tracks, and you keep thinking, well, I suppose they're eating something, and you just don't realize they're eating your fruit trees.
I saw the chipmunk on top of the waterfall today.
I know, and the squirrels are out now too, so.
They're hungry.
I came out yesterday and I actually sprayed them with my deer and rabbit repellent to hopefully save what's left.
Well, let's go look at your apple crisp.
Then I just didn't even want to look at those.
Actually, they're not apple crisp, are they?
They're honey crisp apples.
Yeah.
Right, well. Let's go take a look at the grapes and the blueberries and see if the rabbits have gotten to them. Well, we do have the wire around the blueberries, but you can see that some extra hungry ones did make their way. Probably put their little feet on the top and just chewed away. The ones that were lower obviously were safer because of the wire. You can see they've been here, chewed that one totally off.
Yep, there's some telltale signs.
Yep. For the most part though, it looks pretty good.
Yeah, you do have right here.
Another one, yep. Oh no, look at that. There. This whole.
Well, look at the branch here. That's disconnected right here.
Yep. Yep, well, definitely some damage. There's another one. Okay, if you just look over here at the picnic table and this bench, you can see how deep the snow still is. I'm going to use this as a sidewalk. Like raccoon footprints. But look at the damage they've done to that bush. That is totally amazing. Now that was a bush that we had moved. We really, you know, it wasn't something that we were really attached to, but it was nice there. It gave a kind of a anchor to this part, but it'll take a long time to recover.
Yep. Well, nature's way of pruning.
may be the saddest part of all, because they have chewed off all of the raspberry bushes. Every last one of them. Everything you see sticking up there would have been a producing raspberry bush for next year.
And oh, this, plus your blackberry. Look at that.
My blackberry.
Totally stripped.
Totally stripped. Except for where it hits the ground, they actually didn't eat the main stalk, so that will send out new shoots, but still have a long way to go before the snow is gone, and we'll have to see. But look at that. I mean, they chewed the top right off. And then they chewed all the branches, they girdled it again, they chewed a hole right in here. Yes, why would that possibly stop a rabbit, you may ask? It does every summer. You just don't think that it's gonna be different come winter time, but obviously they are a lot more hungry in the winter and they'll go for anything they can get. These were my apple trees. I was looking forward to them. They helped themselves.
Well, we may have to get a couple new ones, and I think not knowing what's going to happen, we're really going to have to wrap them and even put wire caging around them.
Right. They'll have to have a bigger wire.
Yeah.
Definitely wire cage.
Amazing.
I want to go look at the peach trees. I didn't even dare look at those the other day, but they should be big enough, but let's look.
Be careful. I fell into a hole a couple of feet deep.
I know. On the way to the peach trees, we stopped to look at some of our raspberry bushes. And sure enough, look at that. All along here.
There's a telltale sign.
Yep.
Hungry little critters.
Yeah, they chewed them way down to the ground there. You can see those. Look at that.
Oh, yeah. Get them over there, too.
In the garden too. Yeah. They're way over the fence. They just hopped right over the fence.
I mean, look at the snow. This fence, the snow is up to the fence.
Yep. It'll be a while.
I mean, that snow right now is between 2 and 3 foot tall. I've got snow in my boots.
I bet you do. Now, this is a sign of life, and this is a sign of something that's so tough. This is a rhododendron bush, and in the winter, I try to make sure that I cover it up when we're shoveling, and the leaves will actually curl, but they always stay green. It just amazes me. And look on that one. You can see the bud that will be a flower. Here's another one. Now, I guess the rabbits don't care for those because hopefully they'll just leave them alone.
It mustn't be very sweet.
No. Now, peach trees look good. They look very good, but you can see how big around they are, which wouldn't stop a rabbit if they were really, really hungry. But I think they'll be okay. Let me just go look at the apricot tree. I thought these were okay, but no, they aren't. Look at that. This is our apricot.
Yeah, and in the back there
and
too.
In the back and right here. So we may have to get some more spray out and give this another spray just to help protect it for the rest of the winter time.
It's dangerous walking out here.
I'm so much taller than you now.
Yeah. Not for long. Take one step. And,
I know. I don't even dare to move because if I sink just as I am. These are our burning bushes. They love these burning bushes. And you can see they have their own little hole here where they just sit and nibble. shoot off all the tops. And you can see that there's a track there. And that's either voles, a vole track, or a mouse track. I want to say voles. Everything has to eat, so you have to expect that there will be some damage to your plants, regardless of how well you plan, because food is a necessity. And unless we get a coyote here soon, we'll probably have to take better precautions come summer, too.
Well, nature has its own agenda.
Mm-hmm. Well, survival of the fittest, so that means eating your burning bushes and your apple trees, then that's what they're going to do.
Yeah, we'd love to hear how other people are coping with this most unusual winter with regards to all of their garden goodies.
Right, and if you've had more snow than we, where I know some of you have, you probably can't even see what's happened yet. So thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this, or didn't enjoy it, but actually appreciated, you know, what happens, please give us a thumbs up. We'd love to hear from you and see what's going on in your area. And always, we'd love to have you subscribe.
And what about people who are having problems getting messages?
Oh, yes. With this new Google Plus thing, I sometimes have a problem answering you when you leave me comments. Can't always get to an inbox. Sometimes it's on the follow part. So, you know, if you do leave a message and I don't answer you within a reasonable time, please send another one and I'll try a different way.
Or send it to you at Lynn
at wisconsingarden.com.